Welcome back to day 7 of the 52nd ISSF World Championships here in Changwon, Korea. We're in the finals hall of the Changwon International Shooting Range. This is the third final today. It's been another busy day here in Korea. We had the three positions women's final, followed by the trap mixed team junior final as well. All results are online on the ISSF website, and Facebook and Twitter. But we are now back with the 25-meter pistol women's final. Medals and Olympic quota places up for grabs. My name is Jamie Stangroom, and I am joined by Antonetta Bonova, pistol shooter from Bulgaria. Hello, Antonetta.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
That's good to know, and we will find out more about how you're feeling and what's happening around us in just a few moments. But I'm going to hand over to our announcer here in the finals hall, Shaq, who is going to introduce the audience in Changwon and you at home to our 8 finalists competing in the 25-meter pistol women's event. So here's Shaq.
Representing Germany, the world number 6 won silver at this year's ISSF World Cup in Mexico, Doreen Vellenkamp.
Also has European Championships junior bronze from Bologna, 2012 to her name, world number 6.
Chinese Taipei, she finished 4th at the 2016 World Cup in Thailand, Tien Chia Tsun.
She did compete at the World Championships in Granada, 2014. Making her first final appearance here today in a World Championship. Has competed at a number of World Cups, Asian Games as well this year in Jakarta.
Representing Germany, the Olympic silver medalist, World Cup gold medalist, and current European Games champion, Monica Karsch.
Current world record holder, did make the final in Granada. She'll be looking to build on the 6th place that she achieved there 4 years ago. Biggest cheer so far, as you'd expect. Crowd's favourite, home advantage perhaps.
She makes her first ever international final, Aldana Saad Al Mubarak.
Also was at Granada for the World Championships there, but as Shaq mentioned, making her first final at an international event here today.
Representing the Russian Federation, a World Cup silver medalist, and the 2015 junior European champion, the Wolf, Vitalina Vasilina.
Just 21 years of age, just missed out on the final in Granada in this event, placing 9th. Current world number 10 and 2-time ISSF Shooter of the Year 2002 and 2011 were those years. So, a reminder that my guest is Antonetta Bonova of Bulgaria, pistol shooter. She's competed at Olympics and she has, let's have a look at this, 14 World Cup medals to her name. There's European Championship medals as well. Competed at, well, this is the 4th World Championships you've competed at now. So Munich, Zagreb, Granada, yeah, and now Changwon. But you've been away from the sport for a little while, haven't you?
Yeah, I have to make a little rest because I have my second child.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
A daughter?
Daughter, yeah. She's 6 months only. And I think it's a good beginning for me.
This is your first competition
yeah,
since,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, this is my first competition.
And how has it been adapting back into shooting sport?
Actually, for the air pistol, I was very nervous. Like I made a rest not only 1.5 year, but more. And really, it was difficult for me to come back. But for the sport pistol, I was okay. But of course, it's not a small time without competitions. And
no, it's a long time.
It was difficult.
How long
yeah,
were
yeah.
you out for? I mean, I've never been pregnant before, so I'm not sure. How long were you away for?
My last competition was European Championship in Baku, but
which was last year, wasn't it?
Yes, but it was only in 25 meter. For 10 meter, it was World Cup in Munich. So for the air pistol, year and a half without competition, and for the sport pistol, one year.
But you're back now, so welcome back. And for you guys at home, if anyone's new to this sport, to this particular event maybe, this is the 25-meter women's event, and as you can hear, it's a noisy one. We're going to have 10 series of five shots in total, and it's hit or miss scoring. So basically, that's a 10.2 or higher is classed as a hit. And after the fourth series, we'll have our first elimination, so eighth place will go then, and that will continue. The 10 series have concluded, and our gold medals have been settled, plus silver, bronze, of course, and four quota places. So four quota places are up for grabs for the athletes in the top four. That sounds about right, doesn't it?
Yeah, and actually here is everyone can take a quota because nobody already have it.
That's true. If an athlete had picked up a quota from another event, they wouldn't be able to take a second quota here. So, yeah, you're right. Everyone shooting here can take a quota for their country. And it's Alena Kostovic off to a perfect start. Five hits.
Actually, for me, the surprise is the girl from Qatar, because nobody expect that she will go to the final.
Al Mubarak on firing point G.
I think this is from Qatar. Is the first time someone is in the final, and
it's I mean,
the world championship.
It's possible. I mean, it's certainly the first international final for Al Mubarak. We're seeing
out
there.
Yeah, yeah, but I mean, for the country, all not only for her.
And you notice as well, she's a left-handed shooter, isn't she? And she got off to a decent start, three hits. But it's a very tough event, isn't it? You know, 10.2 or higher. And it used to be 10, am I right in saying it used to be 10 and now it's 10.2?
Yeah, 10.2. 10.0 and 10.1. Just missed, it's not a point. Something went, I'm not agree, but nobody asked me. Actually, we are the first, we are the only shooting discipline that 10.0 and 10.1 is not a point. Like, you didn't shoot nothing.
Yeah, so it's just made the event harder, if anything.
Yeah.
But I guess that's part of sport, you know? It's at this level, it's not going to be easy, and it's still Alena Kostovic making it look easy right now. She's got 10 out of 10. That's at one more than Batsharishkina of Russia on 9. And it's our shooter from Singapore, Teh, in 8th place.
Actually, it's not so small distance because before Olena and Batsharishkina and look the other one.
Yes, we've
three,
got
2 points.
Three athletes on 6 hits. They're tied in 3rd spot. And we should mention as well, actually, when it comes to the eliminations, we're actually halfway towards our first one. If we have a tie-break situation, then there will be an additional tie-breaking series to settle that tie. So this is the 3rd series now. And who are your favourites out there, Antonetta? You're allowed favourites or one favourite?
Like European, I prefer the European girls.
You spend more time with them, I guess, don't you?
Yeah, of course. But for here, my favourite is
Alena.
Yeah.
Well, she got off to a good start. She's had her first misses, though, in this series.
That's so good.
Good series so far for Batsharishkina and also Venny Kamp of Germany. Wow. just one hit for Kostovic. The moment you said that she's your favorite and she started to slip. So she's now in second and it's back to Akina.
Oh, so you hold back my words.
Yeah, well, you've got Vitolina in top spot.
No.
Kostovic isn't out of it now. Oh, is Vitolina not your favorite? So there's three separating those two shooters. And it is Tet of Singapore sharing seventh place with Kash of Germany. So they're both on six, and the next series is the fourth series. So that will decide who takes the first elimination from this final. So our two athletes tied there in seventh. If it stayed that way, as I mentioned, we would have an extra additional series to settle that tie.
Well, like you can see, everything can happen.
It really can. Yeah, one series changed a lot in that table. Lee and Ten are both tied in fourth. And it's Venikamp up into third place. And she's only one behind Kostovic in second.
And she's one of the youngest shooters here, Doreen.
Yeah, 23 years of age, 4 months and 25 days. Who knew? I guess her parents did. A few misses there, half hit, half missed, and about eight finalists. It's Kash, and at 10. Kash has missed the first three. Tez hit one. So it will currently be Kash. Back tied again now. One hit each. Kash and Teh. Comes down to this shot and a miss for Teh. Hit for Kash. So Kash will stay in. And it's Teh of Singapore taking eighth place in this final. Finished on seven hits. So one short of her closest rival, Kash of Germany. So Teh Shihor of Singapore takes a bow for eighth place, her first World Championships. First final, 24 years of age, and it's her best finish, actually, in any ISSF event. So congratulations to her. And now the eliminations continue, don't they, Antonetta? After every series, another will take place. So what's happening at the top?
Look at Tereshkina, three full series in a row.
Wow, so she is the shooter to catch right now on 19 hits, and that's four more.
4 points difference.
Then Kostovic, her closest rival. And Venikamp, as you mentioned, the youngest shooter, she's still in the mix. She's in third place, two behind second. But in the danger zone is Kash, so she's got to do it again. She's one behind her closest rival, who we spoke about earlier, Mubarak, left-handed shooter from Qatar, in her first final. She's on your screen there, as is Lee of Korea.
Attention.
For Kash so far, Al Mubarak has hit one. She's now got a lead. Kash strikes back though, one behind now. That's Tereshkina is going well again. So Kash will need to hit this and hope that Al Mubarak misses to force a shoot off. Kash hits, and Mubarak misses, so we've got that shoot-off.
The first shoot-off.
Yeah, it was four hits for the top three, Venikamp, Kostovic, and Bats Tereshkina. So, tie-break situation, so we have an additional series for Kash of Germany and Mubarak of Qatar. And this is, how what goes through your mind when you're out there in a situation like this, when it's you?
It's better to don't think about nothing else, only for the work that you have to do, and try to fix only that.
Mm. But I suppose this is one of the most high-pressured situations, isn't it?
I can feel the pressure only for here.
There they go.
Attention!
Kash takes the lead in the shoot-off, still free to go.
Good.
Oh, two-hit lead now for Kash of Germany. So she hits this, she's safe, she's done it again.
Yes.
And she does. I think you're happy by that.
Yeah, I am. Bravo.
So the shoot-off finishes 4-1. Monica Kash remains in the competition. Aldana Saad Al Mubarak of Qatar takes seventh place, competing in her first final at an international event. She was in Granada 4 years ago.
Congratulations to her. That's her first.
And she has recorded her best finish at an international event there, with seventh at this World Championship. Just 24 years of age, so I'm sure we'll see a lot more from her as competitions go on. Right, so at the top, we've had no change because we had four hits for Bachelor-Aquino, four hits for Kostovic, four hits for Venikamp in that last series. So that's the standings at the top. And in the danger zone, it's Kash. She's got to do it again for the third time now. She's two behind Lee of Korea, a locals' favourite here in Changwon.
Monica needs a very strong series now, because 2 points difference is not so small.
No, it's not.
Here.
Attention.
But she's avoided elimination twice.
Mm-hmm.
You never know, she could do it again.
No, she's just one of the strongest shooters that I ever know.
And she's off to a hitting start. Only two of our six athletes hit their first.
Good.
Two hits for Kash, one for Lee, so she's closed the gap to one. That's the difference. Three to two now. I'm looking at Kash and Lee. There's Kash on your screen. So she's still one behind Korea. Still one behind. So she'll need to hit. Lee will need to miss.
There is a chance for another.
Another shoot-off,
oh, no.
Yeah, possibly.
Oh, yeah.
And we have. Ah. We have once again with Lee missing that last. And Kash hitting. It does mean they're both tied on 16. So once again, Monica Kash of Germany has a chance to survive potential elimination, and she's going to have to do it. Vara shoot-off, second time on the trot. She's up against Lee of Korea, who will have the biggest support from the audience here.
Because, of course,
we are in Changwon, Korea. And it was three hits for Bachelor-Aquino, Kostovic as well. So they are still the top two. Venikamp hit four, so she's closed the gap a little bit on second, just one behind. Kostovic's lead is still four at the top. And it's Dien, Chinese Taipei, in fourth place on 18. So a little bit behind the top three, but comfortable enough ahead of fifth and sixth, who we're looking at now in the shoot-off. Both get off to a missing start. Would you say that Monica perhaps has the advantage here because this is her second shooter?
It's not so sure, because when you shoot too many,
it's the energy, I suppose, isn't it? Mentally and physically.
Not mentally, but the physical.
Well,
yeah.
She's looking good here.
No, it's decided.
Yeah. She's done it again.
Yeah.
2-0. So Antonetta is happy again, but she did it the hard way for the second time on the trot via a shoot-off. And this is Lee Jong-un of the Republic of Korea, taking sixth place here, finishing on at 16 hits and just missing out via a shoot-off. And that's her best finish.
Yeah, now 2 points difference again between Monica and Chinese Taipei.
So yeah, she's got to do it all over again, Monica Cash. Like you said, 16, and Tien is on 18.
Can she do it for a third time?
I mean, you can't rule her out now, can you? You can't.
Can we?
Anything can happen. She's proved that. Meanwhile, at the top, as we said, Bachiwakina is still there, and she's at four ahead. She's still got that commanding lead over Kostovic. Venikamp just one behind. So we still have two German shooters in this final, and we're one elimination away from the quota places being decided. So Germany can take two. If there were three German shooters in the top four, then it would actually go to fifth place, because only two athletes from one country in an event can take a quota place each.
Attention.
Monica Cash, the only one to miss. That's not what she needs. So Monica Cash, three hits behind. Will take fifth place in this final.
Yeah, she will be in the fifth place.
And she finishes on 18 hits. It was four short of TM in fourth place. So Monica Cash, I mean, she could have been eliminated in eighth, seventh, and sixth. So taking fifth place is a great achievement in the end. And her country have taken a quota place, so it's great for great for Germany.
Yeah, now we can see the quota place.
We can. So Russia, yeah. Ukraine, Germany, and Chinese Taipei. They take the quota places. So Kostovic still in second, and she's now only three behind Bachiwakina. So that was four. That's gone down. And Venikamp also hit four, just like Kostovic there, so she's still just one behind. But Tien's got some work to do now, hasn't she? She's three behind safety.
No, 3 points is too much, but not impossible, but very, very difficult.
Yeah, but you never know. You
yeah,
never
yeah,
know.
Of course.
And whatever happens, Tien has secured that quota place. Ready. She's going to have to make up that big difference if she wants to add a medal to that.
Attention.
So here we go. This series is for fourth place.
Nobody wants to be in the fourth place.
No, but I suppose at least with this competition, you have got the quota place. You know?
Yeah, but without medal.
True, true. And of course, the quota place, you're winning for your country. It's not an individual
thing, is it?
Yeah,
it's not personal, yeah.
She hit four out of five. Atel's 26. It's still one short of Venikamp. So fourth place will go to Tien Jiajen of Chinese Taipei. So she leaves without a medal, but she does leave with a quota place for her country and her best finish at a world championship. So
it means that the podium will be only with European.
It will, which means you're happy. All your friends are on the podium.
Yes.
So, Vitalina Bachiwakina of Russia is the leader. She's still
with only 1 point.
Yeah, leader. That's the shortest lead she's had in a while now, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. She's hit 3-3-2. Her last three series, Kostovic 3-4-4. So it is just one between them now. And Venikam has slipped behind after hitting two to Kostovic's four there. She's now three behind second. So currently in the bronze medal position.
Next series. Ready.
So this series is for the first medal. Venikam, the youngest shooter, left in this final.
Actually, it's almost decided.
Well, there's three hits. You never know. And I said she's the youngest shooter. Actually, she's not. She's the second youngest. Bachio Aquino is 21. 23. Is now level with Bachio Aquino.
Actually, this is the third final for Vitalina. In a mix was the first one, then in the air, and now again.
I think you're right. Yeah, I think you're right.
She missed the quarter place in the air pistol, but now she
and you
take
can,
it.
You can take a medal in a mixed team event and still take quarter place
sure.
in the individual. Yeah, you can. But there we have confirmation.
Oh.
Doreen Venikam taking the bronze medal for Germany with 31 hits to her name. That's her first World Championship medal for the world number six. 23 years of age, takes a bow. Big cheers from her teammates in the audience there.
Vitalina and Olena.
Wow, so we have got an interesting final series. I say final series, it may not be the final series. So how are you feeling right now? I mean, is Elena your outright favourite?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's see what happens for you then. Of course, if it remained this way after the next series, we would have another of those shoot-offs. We've had two of them already in this final. The world record is 39, by the way, so there's a chance to equal that or break that, Anna Korakaki's world record.
I think she made it in the World Cup final in Bologna.
Yes, you're right. Mm. In 2016.
I was there.
You're right.
Yeah.
Wow, and now you're here to see it potentially get broken.
Hmm?
Let's see.
Attention.
Here we go. One for Bachio Aquino. Here we go. It's now 1-1. So they can only equal the world record if either of them. Nope, that can't happen now. The world record can't be equaled, can't be broken.
Can you see the shots? The both of them shoots 10th, but 10.0 and 10.1.
Wow.
That's
so
why
close.
It's not the case.
So close.
Yeah.
Oh, and we've got a shoot-off.
Again.
Both finish on 37, so two shy of that world record we talked about, but it's a shoot-off for the third time in this final. So we go again. It's sudden death in terms of these series now for the gold medal. How are you feeling, Antonetta, with your favourite down there?
Yeah.
In a bit of a battle.
Again, Olena.
So Lina Kostovic against Vitalina Bachio Aquino, both experienced shooters. In this event, Kostovic has picked up her first World Championship medal. Same for Vitalina as well.
The experience on the side of Kostovic. So.
Oh, Kostovic. Takes first blood. 2-1. I can tell you at home that Antonetta is on the edge of her seat, literally. It's 2-2. She's edged back into her seat now. Three-three, one shot left in this series.
Can they make it again?
Oh!
They do. It's another shoot-off, the fourth in total in this final, the second to decide potentially the gold medal. So Baturkina and Kostovic go again now.
Very strong shooters.
They are, aren't they? And it's just a case of who breaks first, isn't it, I suppose? Just got to keep concentrating.
Can you imagine how big is the pressure now?
I can't imagine. I mean, you must have been in these situations, so only you can really describe it.
Attention. It's not a good feeling.
Well, I'm sure if you come out the right way, the right end of one, it must be a pretty good feeling. So let's see who will have that feeling at the end of this. It's 2-1 to Baturkina. Oh, there's a... for Baturkina. Kostovic seems to have some sort of problem. She raised her hand. A malfunction. So that's now being investigated. Meanwhile, Baturkina hit 4 out of 5. Kostovic on 1 as things stand. As the gun is inspected. Just waiting for the result. Didn't quite hear what he said, did you?
How many shots you get?
Malfunction, allowable. 2 shots fired.
2 shots fired.
Oh, that means doesn't matter how... Yeah, I have to be 3, or no?
So was that 2 shots fired? Kostovic has 3 left.
Malfunction 3, ready.
So if she has 3 shots left, then she's gotta hit all 3. She's gotta hit all 3. Goes. It's a hit. 2 more to force another shoot off. One more. She does it. So, we have a third shoot-off now between these two athletes. Antonetta, you enjoyed that moment, didn't you, a lot?
What a
great comeback.
Look what means the experience. When you have experience in your side.
There is a fourth shoot-off.
And she really does. I mean, Vitalina is experienced for a young age of 21, but
yeah,
Alina,
yeah,
you know, it's twice that, really. Twice that,
everybody
really.
Everybody knows Alina.
Okay, so we got to do it again. And maybe even again after that. The way this is going between these two. Nothing between them.
Attention. Oh,
someone has to break down there.
I think they're very tired now.
One to Kostovic. Thank you. 2-1. Three remaining. Remains 2-1. Two shots left in this series. Third tiebreak series for the gold medal to be crowned world champion. So Kostovic hits and she will take the gold. She misses, but so does Bekhtarekina. So Elena Kostovic of Ukraine takes the gold medal. She is the world champion. Quota place on top of all that as well. So a great day at the office. She got there eventually anyway.
She deserved it.
How would you sum up that final then, Antonetta Bonneva? How would you sum it up in just a couple of sentences? We had everything, didn't we?
Yeah, very good final. It was a really good final.
It was a long
very
one.
Very difficult for them.
Yeah, how many shoot-offs in total? There was three for the guys at the end. I think we had maybe six in total during the final, or five or six. It was a long, energy-zapping final. And that's just for us. Mm-hmm. I don't know how they feel down there. But it was Alina
Kostovic. No, actually, I prefer to be there.
You prefer to be there? Well, you'll be back there. You'll be back there. You've just come back, you know, and we're going to see you back down there again in finals, I am sure. But Alina Kostovic of Ukraine takes the gold medal. She's the world champion. Vitalina Bachelagina takes the silver. And there's Doreen Venekamp of Germany, who took the bronze. And, of course, quota place. So Ukraine, Russia, Germany, and Chinese Taipei with the quota places. We're going to be back again. We're not done. We've got the junior 25-meter pistol women's final coming up at 4:45 local time here in Changwon. Stats in approximately 43 minutes time. So thank you for now for joining us. And thank you to Antonetta Bonneva, my guest.
You're welcome.
And again, hope to see you down there in a final soon at a future competition. So thank you for joining me and thank you at home. We'll be back at 4:45, amazing, but for now that's all from Changwon.
Absolutely amazing. Congratulations to the girls. And thank you very much for your support. As always, the victory ceremonies will begin at 5:45 p.m. in the plaza on the left-hand side. The next final is in the shotgun range. No, it's not. No, the next final is here. The next final is here. It's the junior women's 25-meter pistol at 4:45 p.m. Little rest, and then the junior women's 25-meter pistol. Thank you very much. Congratulations to them. Kamsa hamnida. the bronze medal representing Germany goes to Doreen Vennenkamp. The silver medal representing the Russian Federation goes to Vitalina Batsarashkina. Gold medalist and world champion representing Ukraine, Olena Kostevich. Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of Ukraine.
모두 자리에서 일어나 주시기 바랍니다. 우크라이나의 국가 연주가 있겠습니다.
Photographs of the medal winners.
네, 수상자들의 사진 촬영이 이어지고 있습니다.